manuals here, and so I think what we can do is we'll be very quick, because I know you're busy. So let's first of all use a lateral approach. We'll just do the femur. We use a lateral approach, and I'm really chagrined about not having our handling. So we go, we found out the best way to is between the distal third and the middle third. And so, where's that drill we have?
It's actually a drill.
It's a pretty long bit you got there, though.
Let me see if I can use this.
Okay.
Yeah. Found that the direct one to the canal is at the posterior third. I'm gonna use this step drill. I'm kind of going by the principle that the surgeon is skillful based on the tools he can do without him. I really should have checked over. We didn't have the reamers.
So you usually use a series of hand reamers?
Yes.
At advanced size?
Yeah.
No power.
No power. We can't use power. I mean, we don't have it.
So how do you, I mean, you just make your incision big enough that you go down and put your finger right on the
incision's trope. Like this.
You just put your finger on it.
Yeah, you can feel it in a lateral position.
Patients aren't too obese.
There's a variable quality of these Sawbones. I suspect this one has a pink interior, which are much harder to use. I just hope I can get this in. We're going to use, and I'll show you how we really use it. And I'm going to make this hole bigger with our screw hole brooch.
These are made in the Tri-Cities?
Yes. Everything's made in the Tri-Cities.
You can come to the conference in September, see the whole factory, and get a tour of the factory. And learn from all the
We're still developing. We developed the hip, the pediatric. We're working on what we call a compressor for tibia plateau fractures. We try to do the worst fractures first. We're doing femoral neck. Every time we change an indication, we have to go through FDA. And that is a real pain. I don't mind being quoted.
And say you have a closed, mid-shot fracture. How do you reduce it without CR and without opening? Or do you open?
Mid-shot, we open.
Okay.
But when you open, you don't need to make an incision. What you do is you feel the fracture, and then you try to put your hand into the fracture site, because a lot of times there's been enough force to tear a hole in the muscle. And then you go down to the fracture through. I never cut a muscle, and I don't bovie it. I use a periost elevator to go through, because a lot of times we don't have blood either. So we go through there, down there. Once we get there, we can feel it. We line it up. And see, we're not using power, so we can use hand reamers, and it's a little safer. So we'll do one nail first. So let's say we decide on this size.
So what's the size of your final reamer relative to the nail?
Two millimeters bigger.
Okay.
And this is going to be a chore.
Do you want to use one of your Pete's nails?
Huh?
The Pete's nail? Oh, that doesn't have a distal interlock, so you don't do this.
Yeah, I can tell you that these the fin nail will be used more and more by science. So
what size nails are there?
Yeah. We have 8 through 12, and then we have
in millimeters.
Two.
Yeah,
we always go millimeter, and then we have in length we have 190 to 420. There's a big variety of bone. I mean, you can look around this group, but the Dinkas in South Sudan have tibias 420 and more. We're training those guys. I'm gonna see if I can get this little nail through this hole.
Want a big hammer?
He doesn't think I can.
I don't think so. Now you got a little challenge. I don't see it happening.
Okay.
So what makes a surgeon a science surgeon?
Doing science surgery.
You just show up and like, oh, these are the nails we got, so.
Well, it's
is there
usually
a training
the
that they
scenes,
get?
Yeah.
So it's not uncommon for a surgeon in the U.S. to go to Lou and say, I got some donations from Rotary. Rotary will sponsor me, $20,000. And that's about the cost of one of your sets. Is that right, Lou? So
yeah.
It's a selection of nails and interlocks and tools to insert. And you will go to a country that's interested in having this equipment, spend a week there, and teach
and
those
teach
surgeons
how
to do it. Mostly they'll teach you how to get it done. And then every time they do a case, they enter it on the web, on the database. And Lou sends the replacement implants. So you put in a nail and two interlocks, and you put it on the database. And then they send them the replacement implant. So it's a self-generating system once you take the first set to a country.
Yeah, or you can go. I mean, if you want to have a good time, you go to a sign program. I mean, it's just pure fun. I don't know where this. This one's not quite lined up with the canal. See, it's in the middle. There's a 1.5 degree bend down here, and so. If you move it just a little bit, I bet you this one does not have a pink.
Yeah, these are some of both types.
Yeah, well, thank you. You know, it's incredible.
Minor softer.
So then we don't, when we get here, I want to show you something. Watch the femoral neck. What happens when you try to force this? And I'm just going to hit this end. See how? Oops. That's way over. So we that's a little bit extreme. And we try to leave 3 millimeters up here because a nail surrounded by cortical bone, much more stability. Sure. So that we've got that. Okay, I want to see. Okay. I just want to see if I can get it in.
No, it's ready.
No. There you go. So we line these up. Middle portion. Okay.
So you line it up before you put the nail in.
Yeah, I'm just going to line it up now.
Yeah, so
I mean, I'm going to drill it in. Exactly. You line it up before. Now, and there's a lot of nuances to this. I'm going to see this
one. So where's the money come for the nails and the that you send out?
That's the hard part.
Yeah.
I can just tell you that we have enough funding to go on for 20 or 30 years.
So you trust.
But we want to increase.
Yeah. Totally.
Now, okay, so this is a 280. And so I'm going to go to the 280 mark. Okay? And it's over here. And I put this. So 280 will be here and here. Okay, so we'll put this in down from here. We had to tighten this up. It's been a process of it's been a process as we it's kind of important to take it off.
Don't put the nail in with that.
Huh?
Don't put the nail in with that.
Yeah, some people do that. I got Dave Templeton doing that. So we use a tissue protector, and this is kind of a neat one. It's so malleable. Put it in like this to keep it off the skin. Direct this a little bit. Now we're going to deal with this. Okay, and then I use that alignment pin again just to dimple the skin, you know, and then we make an incision through the sin, tensor fascia lata, periosteo elevator down to the bone. And then I turn it right angle to get to the bone. Okay, so we've done that. There's nothing else I'm here to demonstrate on. We put that in. And make it little. Now, take this out.
You have some jump from there, too.
I think that's been in a long time. We use I'm not going to show you. We make a hole through one cortex only. And then we use a larger one. Step row. Yeah. That's exactly what I do. I hold that so it doesn't drift. Am I in that hole?
Yeah. Just one cortex, right?
Yeah, and then we're in. I don't like to push it anymore because if you make a and then it doesn't work. I kind of wished I had missed so I could show you our backup. we really have a good backup. Now, this is called a slot finder. Everything is kind of named. This is a hip nail. But everything's kind of named, so if you put it into the hole and rotate it, it doesn't move at all. It's caught in the hole. Use a screw hole brooch. If it does move about 10 degrees, if it moves too much, you're not in the hole either. So we'll see if we're in the hole. We line it up and we see we're in the hole.
Bam.
And I did a little maneuver here. I changed the rotation a little bit. Rotation is key. And that's what all of the implant companies that have tried to do this don't understand the difference between longitudinal orientation and rotation. Because rotation is by this, longitudinal is by this. And so then we take...
So what's the fix if you don't get it?
Huh?
What's the fix if you don't get it?
The fix is the curved slot finder. You take this off, and you can always find it with this. Unless the fracture has changed, because that would be longitudinal. Mm-hmm. Unless the nail has come up or down.
Okay.
But this is really, works really well. All of these things are just kind of, you go on a trip, you think of an idea, how can we fix it? Now this one's cannulated. So I put this in. Through the other side.
Really well done.
We've got the hole through the other side. Depth gauge, put it through here, and that's just used to mark the hole. And then you take it out, measure on the cannula, not the drill guide, and you add 5 millimeters because you'd like to be 3 millimeters above and 3 below. So this measures about 36. So we can go 40 or 45. Let's go 40. This will be a little less prominent than we like. And I always kind of lift this up, especially in the proxima. The optimum strength of a screw is 2 threads on the other side and 2 threads on this side. Okay. And so the other way we can say we in is to do this. We know we're in. Okay. So, thank you for finding that.
Yes.
You're welcome to do these. As long as you want, and I'll be here. We can answer questions, or we can talk about technique, or whatever you want to talk about. All
right. Excellent.
Yeah, we have, thank you.
Cool. Sure. So we have lots of sawbones, and we have one drill, so we'll have to share drills. Drill.
Yeah.
Drill.
it seems like these sawbones that don't feel the ones that seem more plasticky are going to be the ones that work best. Should be the ones that are up, and then let's just
and going from
play with
this
the stuff.
You can put this in here and just go.
Put everything together.
That's how you
together.
Find your second one.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Does that engage the screw heads?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just enough. And this was just another thing we did.
Oh, that's great.
I couldn't be happier. I love to do this.
Yeah, yeah. I bet.
Okay, so
all right.
I'll answer questions, or I'll just go around whatever you guys want.
Straight out this
humor.
What's that?
We made the center like this, so there's no threads in there.
Especially increasing strength of the bolt.
Yeah.
What is it? Just
there were cuts at one of the conferences, and using those to fix OCD lesions.
Did you think
they had? Like, they're like, "Please, we can fix them." There's a whole thing behind it.
The cream is on this thing.
Hey, it's the exact same thing.
Right.
Right.
I don't know who it
was.
So these are okay. Usually, you and Sturgis lose the bend and the anterior. Is that pretty typical? Because insertion.
This hole has been drilled a little anterior.
These are the better ones from my box.
Yeah.
Calvin? It should have took 2 hours to fit.
Go around with screw-hole brooch.
Screw-hole brooch. Oh, I think they took it from
us. Yeah. Oh, we got it. Yeah. It's still right in there. We got this. We have to broach. Yeah. You guys are doing two. Okay.
Use the words, man. Use your words.
Hand me that.
Well, I do half a week in Lyon, where there are a lot of residents. This group I go goes for a whole week, and I'll just be there half a week with them. The group I go with, I'm in North Carolina. And then I'll go to Manawa because the DL is really appreciate my green.
They're very sharp.
That's just